Brand new music from Art Array. Her brand new single just dropped today on her birthday. She calls this Right Now.
Acting up, baby, my nature. Tend to stay away from danger. But tonight I'm contemplating breaking out of the rules. There ain't no wrong or right. Just go on and live your life. Go on and shine your light. Cause the thing is right, alright, alright. Right now, nothing's important. It's right now. Cherish this moment. Doesn't really make sense to wait. Maybe we can jump into it right now.
Yeah.
Right now. Nothing's important. This is right now. Cherish this moment. Doesn't really make sense to wait. Maybe we can jump into it right now. Oh.
This is a DJ E-Boogie exclusive.
Art Array, her brand new single, Right Now, on her birthday. Let's go.
Close your eyes and let it glow. Move your feet like you don't know how. Raise your voice and shout it out loud.
Yeah.
I feel brand new.
More music from Art Array.
I feel brand new.
Celebrating her birthday today.
I feel brand new.
She calls this record Good Times.
I feel brand new.
Happy birthday, Art. Let's go.
You're now rocking with the infamous DJ E Boogie.
Boogie, 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 boogie.
Celebrate my girl Art Array's birthday. Happy birthday, mama. Let's go.
So much about you. You colored in my eyelids. Now I can't live without you.
Okay.
Let it go. To let it shine.
DJ E Boogie, boogie, boogie.
You brighten up my day, yeah, yeah. No more gray skies. You took them all away. Raise your voice and shout it out loud. I
Let's go, Art.
Ain't no pain.
Come on.
Hello, sunshine.
Hey.
Goodbye, rain.
Oh.
Thank you, Earth. Thank you, wind. Cause we came in to win.
Okay.
A brand new you. A brand new me. A brand new us. A brand new we. I'm feeling brand new. I'm feeling brand new. We're feeling brand new.
This is Art Array. She calls this record Good Times. Make sure you get her music available right now on all the streaming platforms, okay? She has a brand new single out that just dropped today called Right Now. Yeah. And today's her birthday as well. Happy birthday, Art.
You're not too big if it's not with DJ E Boogie.
Boogie. Let's keep it moving right here on the platform, your source for brand new music, independent R&B and hip hop. What's up, Cuzzo? How you doing, Keish?
Yeah.
It goes on each and every Tuesday, 4 p.m. Just wanted to give my girl Art Array her flowers today. Yeah. Celebrating a brand new single out right now called Right Now. And also celebrating her birthday today. Happy birthday to you once again, Art. All right?
Yeah.
Right now, we're going to hop over to the West Coast. My girl, Elise 5000, she calls this plug.
Yeah.
Come on.
I'm feeling like blending. Yeah, I'm always on trend. I pull up in the bin. Yeah, I'm only got five. Yeah, he wanna vibe. Yeah, he wanna chill. Got him rolling like pills. It's just a lit and you already know. The hell's rolling in hundreds, they do wanna flow.
Yeah.
Yeah, I'm driving so in the fast lane. Chop a smooth purple coating. I make them holler through whole things. I make them call all my name. My vibe is like drug. You know I got dope. You know I'm the plug.
Yeah, yeah, yeah.
My vibe is like drug. You know I got dope. You gon' fall in love. My vibe is like drug. You know I got dope. You know I'm the plug.
Yeah, yeah, yeah.
My vibe is like drugs. You know I got dope. You gon' fall in love.
That's right, cuz of Art.
You gon' fall in love. You gon' fall in love.
Yeah.
You gon' fall in love. You gon' fall in love.
Yeah.
You gon' fall in love. You gon' fall in love with me. I got that.
At least 5,000. Plug.
Chapo. My vibe is like drugs. You know I got dope. You know I'm the plug.
Yeah.
My vibe is like drugs. You know I got dope. You gon' fall in love.
How could you give up on a good thing? Had a good grip, then you lost me. 5 long years wearing your name.
Let's go. Let's go.
Wild, petty lies, sleeping with a disguise. Can't seem to get it right. Make up your mind. What do you wanna do? I'm not good enough for you no more.
I knew it.
plan when you were down. But you know before you turn. I stuck around and I held you up. Oh, oh. So good as a dream. It's gonna be. Better the one with the security.
Music from Megan Rochelle. She calls this "You Owe Me" on the platform.
I wanna be with you. Throw dirt on my name. It's the love. Thank God I don't need you. Don't wanna be with you. Throw dirt on my name. But you know you can't be better. I was the only one to make you all the one to set you. The whole time I knew the truth. Even when you were down, I don't know before you turned. I stuck around and I held you up. Oh, oh, oh. You're gonna drink me, it's gonna be. That I'm the one with the security. Baby, you know that you owe me. You owe me. You owe me. I'm so tired of dividing my time up and subjecting myself to your lies, boy. Play this game for too long, time to switch it up. Now I'm off with you. I'm so done with you. Don't keep blaming, keep shaming me for your. All your flaws, all your faults, it's just too much. So you can say what you can say if I'm me, but don't let you go. Well, I was the only one that was there for you. Oh, yeah, one was there for you. And the whole time I knew the truth.
Welcome back.
Hey.
It's hot. Welcome back. It is hot. God damn it, man.
Yes.
Welcome back to the Miss O Show.
Yes.
Indeed. We miss y'all.
And
I
we
know
have
y'all
the lovely Miss Nina back with us.
Yeah, you miss me.
I personally was waiting to see the photos, the videos. Did you see anything?
Right. Yeah.
Did you know? Did you see post the videos?
I didn't post nothing.
That ain't got nothing to do.
Uh-huh.
That ain't got nothing to do.
We listening to you.
Mm-hmm.
With
y'all. Well, I had a blast. We thoroughly enjoyed.
We did.
Listen,
we did.
Y'all missed me.
That fucking Dada, man.
We totally missed you, but we totally had a blast with Dada. Dada is so dope. Shout out to Gunline Radio. They are my family. I have known them for umpteen thousand years being on the RIP Radio Network. They are truly family. And we do appreciate Dada for coming in.
Yes, I do.
And filling in for our lovely co-host. Yes, so I can get away from life for a minute.
Getting away from life.
Yeah, tired.
Welcome back.
Did you enjoy your time getting away from life?
I did. It was short-lived, but I went. It was fine.
That's what's up. As long as you had a good time, you spent it well, right?
Yeah. I didn't really do anything because, you know, doing nothing is like doing something.
Yes. Doing nothing is a blessing.
Yeah. So we just sat up and just chilled. Because we
stuff.
Both were tired. It's like, I don't feel like doing anything extraordinary. We're just going to chill. So it wasn't really anything to post, which I want to, like, see a TV on the wall.
Having eight limbs all the time, you know, that ties you out.
Listen, yes.
Eight limbs. You're always busy, always doing something, always reaching.
Oh yeah. My God. So listen, welcome back to the Miss O Show. If I'm a little discombobulated, it's because I am.
Yeah,
for all our listeners that are used to listening to us on Facebook and used to chiming in on Facebook, I apologize for not letting you guys know in advance. I think we mentioned it like a couple of months ago. Yeah, that we would be, Rip Radio Network would be going off of Facebook. So you would have to download that app or watch and listen on some of the other platforms that we post on the bottom of our flyer. Mm-hmm. So March is officially the time where we are no longer on Facebook Live. So, I forgot. We forgot.
Show no.
So, you know,
I remember, but I couldn't remember the day.
No, I forgot.
I remember March.
I forgot altogether because I remember that he said it when he said it a long time ago, but I literally was like, If you're not telling me something or it's not on my calendar or something's popping up, baby, I got so much stuff going on in my mind. I cannot remember what in the hell happened yesterday at 3 o'clock in the afternoon. So
insane.
So I'm just a little discombobulated because you know when you got a routine, you just used to a routine. So but we're good. We're here.
We'll be all right. We adjust.
We'll be all right.
That's right. And taking it off.
We said a long time ago, that's the reason why you need to download that Rip Radio app so that you can definitely check us out and keep in contact with us. We're also live on YouTube, so you can check us out on
Bing
YouTube.
Bong.
All of the comments, you can post your comments there just like you did on Facebook, and we can read them on there. Mm-hmm. We can also read them in the chat, so you can post your comments in chat because we know that you guys love interacting with us, and guess what? We love your interaction.
Yes, you guys make
the Miss O Show, so trust me, we still need to see all your comments and everything. And as you know, we always like to start our show off with an affirmation, some positive juju.
Yes.
So what you got for us
some
tonight?
Zen. Hold on, I gotta go look. All right, guys. So for you, I gotta use my Zen.
Right.
Your Zen, your affirmation for today. I'm gonna start saying this every time. You can't go back and change the beginning, but you can start where you are and change the ending.
Yes. Can we get a repeat on that, please?
You can't go back and change the beginning, but you can start where you are and change the ending.
That's right. That's right. Love it.
I love it. Yeah. I love it.
And all the noise for it.
That is so true. I mean, and people, you know, you can always start over.
Yeah, people hold on to the past too much. So if you do
definitely.
That, you can't really, you know, start anything new if you're holding on to something.
The biggest thing is just start.
Yeah.
Shut up and start.
Pretty
much. That's why I tell people all the time.
And keep going.
keep going.
That's like the biggest thing. And like, I find myself all the time being like, and I think I said this the last time, I was just like, Amika, just keep going. Mm-hmm. Like
keep
those
swimming.
Times when you're like really not feeling things and you're like, mm-hmm. okay, you know what? I'm over all this. I'm like, nope, just keep going. Don't stress. Just keep
it
moving.
Restoring my life. Lord.
Jeez. So,
yeah, but real quick, shout out to Ashley Johnson and Mercedes Porter for tuning in on the Rip Radio app. Big ups to y'all, too.
I can't see.
You know what I'm saying? Capricorn, I see you in the building. Got another one coming on the show, too.
Look at
but anyway, what were you about to say?
Listen,
Capricorn on Capricorn.
I'm going to get it together, though. I promise. I was just going to say, how was everyone's weekends? And weekends with an S with you. We're going to start with you because your ass went here last Monday.
Right. I told you I didn't
do
nothing.
Up to do.
You got, yes, we starting
oh,
with you.
Jesus.
See, that's what happened when you missed.
Exactly.
See how that works?
Don't try
that
to sugarcoat it.
Mm-hmm. That part. Whatever.
But yeah, last time I did some Barry Beige mess, undisclosed locations, undisclosed activity. Now we celebrated our fifth anniversary.
Well, congratulations. Congratulations.
So yeah, we just chilled. And first we had all these plans to do all these amazing things and then fatigue hit in. And we were just like, you know what, let's just sit here and let's order room service and let's just not do anything. So
you did go away, but you just kind of
it was like a staycation, I guess you want to call it, because it wasn't far.
That's nice.
It was we just chilled because at first we wanted to go do all these amazing things, and I said, you know what, I really just want to sit the hell down.
Yeah.
That's like, a vacation.
And even though I sit down, you know, I don't sit down with the do not disturb one, or I don't sit down. I'm always, or I'm on my laptop. I've been on my laptop like crazy. the last couple weeks, and I'm personally sick of looking at this damn thing. So, which brings me to this past weekend, we did the official launch of, remember the thing I said I'm starting, but it's totally out of my lane, so my fuck it factor was high.
Oh, yeah. I remember that. Yes, I do remember that.
Yeah, so we started that. Then we launched that, the Wealth Builders Collective Incorporated. It wasn't supposed to be a business, but they were like, you got to do it. So it is incorporated. And we did our, it wasn't really a launch, it was more of an information event, just to kind of tell about it. So we did that this past weekend on Saturday.
On
thank
that.
You. Yes, and my partner flew in from Alabama, and we just basically had an event talking about everything that we offer and just kind of introducing ourselves, getting some content so we can get started. But yes, all I did. And then I did, of course, my Serenity Sunday. This past Serenity. Sunday, we went and did a little impromptu date, a mommy daughter date. With a painting.
Oh, that's part. Cute.
So, yeah.
And you had a, well, let me see. Was it Saturday? Because the weather was good Saturday, right?
Mm-hmm.
Yeah.
Yeah.
So you had a good day for that.
I did.
Focus or something?
Oh, yeah, yeah, yeah. So afterwards, we went out to Focus. We took the people, some of the people that came, and we got a little section and went to Focus and just celebrated, you know, the first event and celebrating what we were trying to do. And it was fun. I realize I'm not a club person anymore.
Oh, yeah.
Because my feet still hurt. I got on loafers right now. I said, oh, Lord, my feet are like this. And yeah, I realize I'm no longer about the club life. I think it's time for me to accept it and let it go.
That's right.
And yeah, and I'm not about section life either. I learned that too.
You're not about section life?
Mm-mm.
Yeah.
What you mean by that?
I like to dance. I like to mingle, talk to people. I hate being in a section where it's like, you know, you see what I'm saying? Like, y'all just sitting around staring at each other.
Complete.
You like sex? I don't like it because I can sit down.
Complete opposite. And I mean, I guess it's because I like the ability. I like having the ability to sit down and have my own space. But I also like, but I can stand up and dance, and I go out on the dance floor, and then I can come back to my ass down, my feet not hurting, people not bumping up against me.
Yeah, that part's nice. But I just don't like, I feel obligated to, like, you know, because everybody doesn't want to do that. So you kind of want to stay near the people. So yeah, I didn't like that.
I don't be rocking with people. I'd be like, I'm happy to be over here. Oh, I see y'all have fun. Yes, boo. I see you dropping like it's awesome. Excuse me, can I please get some shit?
Yeah.
No, this section's mine. Thank you.
I
am not a section girl. It was cool because, you know, I could sit down because I had heels on. But outside of that, I'm good. I like to be in the crowd. But yeah, that's all I did.
Sound like a nice full couple of weeks, though.
For me, yes. You should be proud. I was like, yo, I'm actually outside right now. That was nice.
That's impressive.
Right? Like,
well, you're always outside.
Who?
You're just not.
Working. Well, no, she's outside.
I was working technically. Yes. I technically was working though.
Yeah,
with the marketing.
See,
you know?
See? Boom. Yeah. Never stop.
What about stop, can't
you,
stop.
Ms. O?
Let's see. So Friday. What the hell did I do Friday? What in the world did I do Friday? Shout out to Sudan the man. He had to make his grand entrance.
That's right.
In case we didn't know he was in
exit.
Yeah,
like, in case we didn't know
he was there, he had to make sure that we knew he was in the building.
They didn't say hi, nothing. I just came and sat down, no knowledge or nothing.
How you doing? So Friday first of all, I started back in the office. I don't want to say full time because I do have one day remote, which is today. Mm-hmm. But I started back in the office in my mind full time because it's from Tuesday to Friday. And let me tell you something, baby, it kicked my ass. Okay, do you understand? Like, day started at 6, you know, commute hour in, you know, working, work out for an hour and a half, go back to work, commute back home an hour, come in the house, you know, and then like I did that. And then so I was tired. So come Friday, I had agreed to go out with one of my girlfriends to Felt at the MGM.
That seems to be the new spot now for people.
I guess, just not for this people.
Really?
Yeah, I've been there a couple of times.
Not this people.
I was never really a fan of it.
Not this people in there. No.
Yeah, like it.
We go back to what we were talking about with the sections. Mm-hmm. I'm a section girl. And
now, they don't have no sections, really, do they?
Well, A little bit. Yeah, they have a couple couches, a little couple, you know, whatever. But the thing was, we went and it was, we were supporting a friend of a friend who was their first event. So I'm like, okay, cool. Well, if we're doing this, I'm for sure there's going to be a place for me to sit down. I just need a chair. It could be an ottoman. It could be an ottoman. Right. It could be a fold-up chair.
I don't
give a damn
down.
What it is. Right. It could be a pillow. Listen, a pillow. I just need to be able to sit down, you know, and working all day. Okay, yeah. So and then you're going into, what I don't like is you're going into the vibe of this is a casino. You know, so you got to walk through the damn casino. So I'm walking through the casino and someone had dropped a pin on the floor. I had high heels on and I'm walking and I stepped on the high heel and I was like, ooh! And I caught myself, thank God, but I almost killed myself in the damn casino. I get there and there's a fucking line.
Oh yeah, of course.
I'm like, wait, like, wait a minute.
Yeah.
I don't do lines.
You'd be like the audacity of them to have a line.
I just don't. I mean,
it's another reason I don't like that place too much.
I'm like,
it's always a line.
Yeah.
I was just blown. So we stood in the line for a nice minute. My feet was hurting. So my feet started hurting before I even got in there. Okay. Because we were standing in line. Get inside. And what I'm telling you was like Jimmy Jam, house party, Jimmy Jam packed. Mm-hmm. Like, excuse me. Oh, okay. Oh, excuse me. Can I get through that type of, you know? And the bar was like, people was like lying back, way back here to try to get a drink. Mm-hmm. That's what I'm saying as far as like why I like the section situation. Yeah. Because if
you got a waitress.
Yeah, you got a waitress. You got a seat. Mm-hmm. Even if all these people are standing around, at least you got a place to sit down. So
yeah, that's true.
It was just a, you know, we stayed for a little bit. But then I was like, yeah, no. And she was like, yeah, no. But I was kind of perturbed because I had.
She was just pissed off all night.
Yeah, your buddy ain't Shaley. Highly annoyed. You gotta understand.
There was too many things going on.
I partied for a long time. I'm almost 44 years old. I partied for a long time. I done did my life of partying. I done partied overseas. I done partied internationally. I did all that shit. So I really love my couch and my movies and my blanket and my drink at home. I love it. Get me out this goddamn house. I gotta have a certain level of a setup. Like, I'm sorry, call it bougie, call it whatever the hell you want to call
that's
it, but
preference.
I paid my dues.
Yeah.
I paid my dues to be in a situation where
I can be
comfortable. I don't have to be standing in the line, people bumping up against me.
Like, I'd be able to.
Listen, yes. I mean,
if I can't do this, yeah, I'm gonna go ahead and go to the next spot.
You let me know how it is. I'll look at everything on Facebook and Instagram, you know.
That's what I tell people all the time. I will.
Listen,
I'm like, I ain't going, but I'm gonna like all your pictures.
Right.
I'll tell you.
I had a few too.
Morally, I mean,
morally, you know, get emotional support.
That's what
I'm baby. That fact. So that was that. And then so we ended up leaving. We went to Diablo Cantina. And so that's still at MGM Grand. We had dinner and everything. And that was cool. But let me tell you something. I had a $30 freaking quesadilla.
The FL? Fuck was in it?
$30.
$30. What the hell was in it?
Nothing but shrimp. Like, it was shrimp in regular quesadilla stuff.
Man,
I could not. I was like, hold up. I didn't know it was $30. I mean, let me get that clear.
Right,
I didn't.
Right.
I didn't order it knowing it was $30. Yeah. I saw a quesadilla and I saw $14 next to the shrimp.
Yeah.
I didn't know that there was a whole other $14 for the basic quesadilla. And then the $14 was for the shrimp.
Yeah.
Wait a minute. It was off the charts.
It was so good. Let's get to that. Was it good?
It was so good.
Because if it was good, you can forgive that a little bit.
I won't forget that night, but I ain't going back and forget it again. $30. We haven't even added in the drinks, okay?
Right.
So if the quesadilla is $30 and one drink is $15, you start doing the math. I was like, yo, okay, I'm staying home. It costs way too much to go outside. So shout out to FNF Girl.
That's my child.
Oh, Hey,
I forgot we got
stream. Watch it from here.
Oh, sip now.
Hey, baby girl. Thank you for watching, baby girl.
I forgot she uses this channel. She like, oh, I'm finna get out of here.
It's okay.
Luckily, we ain't talking about nothing crazy today, so it's okay.
Yeah, I'm just kidding. Yeah. There might be times you gotta put your earphones in, baby girl.
I don't sense a hush. She alright. Hi, Serenity. She can pass that. Hello, Serenity. How are you, love?
Yeah, man. I think that was it. Yeah, that was pretty much it. What did I do Saturday? I think, yeah, Saturday, I just chilled. Me and the hubby just got on the couch.
Oh,
and...
hubby.
Hey, yeah, that joint jumped, didn't it? That joint jumped real quick.
But he didn't graduate.
Finance aid to hubby.
You know,
it's financy.
Financy, oh, that's right.
Oh, it runs together.
Okay,
you
right.
Yeah, it just runs together.
Yeah, she said, I'm just practicing.
I'm just practicing. You know what I'm saying? You're supposed to speak all that into existence.
There you go. There you go.
Yeah, so that was just it. What about you?
Mary B.
Because I saw you. First of all, can we talk about your shirt? Because that
I love that shirt. Like, really?
The color is popping.
That's nice.
It goes with your complexion.
That's
swanky.
The beige. The whole beige.
It's fly as hell.
We won't even be mad
if you do that on a repeat. You know what I'm saying? Like, you need to repeat that for the spring somewhere else.
Kind of just pop
up. Well, see, the weather was warm today. This is your best work today.
You know what I'm saying?
It's your best work.
It was warm today.
We're impressed.
So like, he said, I'm putting on flex on everybody today.
Right.
They ain't even going to be ready for this.
Ain't nothing wrong with that right there. Bing bong, goddamn. It's like, nah.
Bing
bong. My shit started Wednesday. Messing around with you.
What y'all do?
Famous.
Oh shit! I forgot all about
you. Oh, so you went?
Yes.
Last minute.
Yes.
Last minute.
Yes. But you know what? This is the funny part.
Going.
I wasn't.
Yeah, it was the last minute.
Literally, me and my coworker, we do happy hour every single week, and we did happy hour. We was at happy hour in DC, honey, and we was doing our little thing or whatever, and then we left happy hour, and then I was showing her the flyer of that they had, and she was like, well. Cause she living down the street too. We both
might as well go.
She was like, "Well, let's just go by there and just have a drink." So I was like, "All right,
you get
what?
Your drink."
I did, right?
Yeah, I did.
That's good.
I did, and then it ends up being like a little family affair because of course hubby came through and he came through and we just all
sat down and chit chat for a little bit.
But
I haven't been there yet.
I promise. I'm just
that was my first time. That's why I made myself go that particular night because it's been since. Popping since January.
That's what I say. That and felt seems to be the current spot for everybody right now.
That means you just don't go.
Yeah.
wherever is the current spot for everyone, you just don't go
That's
there.
That's what I say. With the
Establishment,
Focus,
there.
And Felt.
Yeah.
The two F's.
I saw
the
a lot
three
of focus.
F's. Felt. Focus and famous.
Oh my God. Just skip those F's.
Skip them.
F those F's. Right. No, don't do that. That's not nice. Shout out to Kev Alexander. We ain't mean that.
Right, right.
You can't do it now.
Kev, mess around talking chicken wings out. You talking chicken wings out. I got him back, though. I got him back.
Why did he throw your chicken wings out?
I guess he thought
he
I left.
He was babysitting
the
chicken wings.
Nah, I thought I left. I don't know. All I know is when I got back, the drink was gone, right along with my drink.
Wiped the whole table down.
The whole table down.
But he got
I'll go one day. I'm trying to make a conscious effort.
What? Conscious effort for what? To do
to
what?
To get out and network and talk.
That's right.
Your ass get out and network and talk.
Yeah,
I do.
Right?
You just don't get out and network and talk with
that's right. Okay, what do
that
I
not the truth?
That is a
that
lie.
Is that not the truth, Mary Bay?
Hold on.
Mary Bay.
Don't do that. Where do I go? Please tell me where I go. Please.
Where you went this weekend?
I went to Focus. That was not by my choice.
Oh, you were dragged there?
Yeah. Because no, seriously. Because I was trying, I was employed. I said, can we please just go to dinner? I didn't want to go out.
Right.
But
right.
She wanted to do it because she wanted to, and I get it. She wanted to treat the people that came with us. So she was like, she got it like that.
Yeah,
she
that makes like, make sense.
Yeah, it was
did
on
they
Saturday.
Have, like, they had another, was that
Daryl's party?
Yeah, Daryl's
and
thing.
I didn't even know because
that's
how out of the loop I am. They were upstairs apparently and I was downstairs. I was in my corner. And she just wanted to get a table to, she got it like that. She can make them kind of moves. Me personally, I'm like, I ain't spending that money. Yeah, I don't know, but now I'm trying to stop being a hermit.
Yeah.
Be proud.
I'm very proud of you. I'm very
well, be proud when I actually do it consistently. I'm not gonna waste your pride.
You said you're gonna.
I'm trying. Yes, I'm trying.
After Wednesday, after Famous, I don't think I stayed there too late. I ended up. That's when the Badly situation started.
Did a lot. That was some Leo energy he had.
Thursday night, we hit Harley, D.C. That was absolutely insane. Then Friday, I live like 6 minutes away from the place. It probably took me like 20 minutes to get home.
Harlot?
Yeah, the on U Street.
That's the hookah lounge.
Oh, Harlot. Okay.
Yeah, Harlot. Yeah. So then he had some Saturday afternoon, but I just hit the Babylon joint. Another great night. Saw people I ain't seen in I don't know how long. Shout out to Diane. Let me see. Oh, and then the pajama party.
Where was the pajama party?
Right.
Where was that?
This was Saturday at Daryl's spot.
Oh, he had. Wait, pause. He did Focus and that.
No.
Wait.
On Saturday. You said it's
no,
a spot.
Saturday he did. Something at the MG. It was Focus.
Friday.
Right.
And then it was Babylon.
Daryl, the fact that we're sitting here trying to decipher your birthday events.
Exactly. Insane.
It's actual dialogue trying to figure out.
Yeah, so.
That's Leo.
So, I didn't make it to the day parties he had, but the night joints I was there. So, after Saturday, wherever he was, I guess it was Focus.
Yeah,
he had pajama party, his house, strippers. Well, if you know Daryl, It was all shout out to Vija Hooker. I saw a little box sitting there.
Oh, we was in there
upstairs and downstairs. Representing,
oh, he had the tank.
Yeah, he had the tank. You know, so
no, we mean
what?
What? No.
But
oh wait, hold on, wait, I'm like, no, so, I'm talking about.
Yeah.
The tank hookah, that's what it's called.
Yeah, it was a big joint.
I was laughing at your face.
But I think
I was looking like, wait, what was it doing?
I think I was like sexually assaulted at that part.
Okay. Did you like it though?
I think I did.
Yeah.
A little bit.
By Scripple.
No, bro. Always a female.
I don't think he would like it if it was a male.
It would have been the party would shut down at that point. It wouldn't have been a party. It wouldn't have been nothing.
So.
Me and Daryl would be beefing and everything. Because I'm going to be mad at him that he invited somebody that would cost me. And then, you know, so definitely
that's commitment. You are a friend.
What?
You went to like all of the shenanigans.
Yeah, that's my dude. Like we support each other. He do the same whenever I used to have my birthday joint. So
you have you have all that too.
Who did what?
You do all that too.
Oh no, I don't have to do all that because all of that is in one night. Fucking
yes. I think I went to one of your events and I was like, yeah, okay,
ratchetry.
It was a good goddamn time.
I think I got molested that night. I went there. But it was by a female. It was a female.
She said it so casually.
Yeah, I mean, but no, it was like she had shots. Like she had shots.
Yeah, you mean the one that was pouring the shots?
Yeah, no. It was like the shot in your mouth and putting your mouth, almost like when you went out in New Orleans, you know.
Yeah.
Yep. I'd be living up.
Good stuff.
It is. I I'm going to get a social life, and I'm going to have cool stories to tell too.
Again, big ups to Badly Boy, man. I appreciate the good weekend. Now, I hope I don't see you again till the summertime, bro.
Legend. I don't know how and where he could have anything else after having all that stuff.
Yeah. Like, six things in 3 days. Yeah. That's crazy.
That's why.
He got energy, because I just...
I would have been tired. Y'all would have been there by yourself.
I would have planned all that stuff, and then I'd have been like, you know what?
I'm like,
all
right, guys, we're sitting on Zoom.
I'd have been like, let me know when it turns out.
Be on Zoom. Hey, y'all. I know you expected me here, but I'm tired. My feet hurt. My feet hurt from one night.
Then he had the nerve on Sunday after late.
He had brunch or something, right?
Had a brunch. Mm. I'm like, bro, nope, I'm tapping out.
He probably still asleep right now.
Yeah. It's going to take a whole week off.
All right, guys. So listen, we got to take a quick break. But let's talk about this show we got going on tonight. Yes. So we are going to be talking about politics.
Mm-hmm. Yes. A little something, because we ain't trying to be like, you know, we ain't trying to be that show.
Yeah, we ain't gonna be stiff with it.
Oh, that is not us.
But yeah. The main big deal is that we have on the show tonight Rodney Red Grant. Yeah. Yes. 2022 yeah. Mayoral Candidate, entertainer, and humanitarian. Yes. He is going to be joining us later on this evening, talking about everything that he has going on. And we cannot wait to talk to him, guys. I am so super excited about that.
It's probably why my daughter's tuning in, because she saw the poster and she was like, Mom, he's running for mayor. I said, yeah. I said, guess what? And I showed her the flyer. She's like,
She was like, you get to talk to him.
Yes, I do.
That is everything dope. And we're so excited for him. So what we're going to do is we're going to take a very, very quick break. And when we come back, guess what we're going to get into? Something I know you guys miss so very much. Transpiration.
Yeah, I love
So
that.
Do not go anywhere. You're live with the Miss O Show with Swangin' and Nina.
CTV All Stars.
Yeah. Welcome to the platform, y'all. We are just getting started.
Touchdown.
Hey.
You don't trust me, but I'm not the one that broke your heart. How bad it must be, knowing you're the reason we've only come so far. You shut down and I back up. That's the only way that I know how to protect myself. Do we tap out or fight for love? I'm not perfect, but in this case, I blame someone else.
We fight.
All because of them.
It's not my fault, don't look at me.
Like,
I'm not your best friend.
You know who I am.
You can't compare me.
I know that I'm better.
Race to the finish, I know I win.
Past and the past. This is from your brother Eric Dawkins. Called Because of Them.
It's out because of them.
I gotta give you the benefit of the doubt, cause I know you're scared. That's why our love is limited. To the point, some days it's like it ain't there. You shut down and I back up. And it's the only way that I know how to protect myself. Do we tap out or fight for love? I'm not perfect, but in this case, I'll blame someone else.
We fight all because of this.
I'm gonna point fingers, but right here where I draw the line. Not really with the he said, she said. Always taking account what's mine. So let the past chill right over there. Should've known no limit around here. Ain't nobody on the field like me. Lugo MVP of the year. So what, do I fight for love? Pull the plug, nah man, stick with it. You know I'm the one to trust. Leave that in the dust. Y'all know I ain't quitting. So don't put that blame on me. They the one that made us feel so distant. If I started this thing, then I'm finishing. Standing in front of you, baby, I'm innocent.
They made it tough on us, and so
I'm done. I'm not your enemy,
it's really killing me.
You can't compare me,
oh,
I know
baby,
I'm not
happy.
you're not doing it big if it's not with DJ E Boogie. Boogie, 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 Boogie.
Yeah. Brand new music, my man Jay Holiday, you remember him, right? Brand new track right here called Ride, right here on the platform. Let's go.
Holiday.
I like it, I like the way your lips feel, kisses sweeter than a honey bun. I want it, I want you naked in the bed, silhouette by the candlelight, yeah. It's been a long day, you had it all. Come let me take all of that pressure off your mind. I'll give you something else to focus on. Hope you're not afraid of heights. Oh, it's that love roller coaster, babe. Show me that you know how to ride. We ain't gotta say too much, just let our bodies do the talking tonight. Swear I see a piece of heaven every time I put your lips to the sky.
Welcome back. And shout out to Trump. I know Trump is like, this bitch got my nerves.
Big up
to Trump. I know he like, I ain't even around her no more. I ain't on a show with her no more, but she got on my everlasting damn nerves. But you know, I love you, brother. I love you to the day I die. And he was able to get us on Facebook Live. So
we're back.
I don't know if it's just for tonight. So it's still under negotiation.
Shout out to the good Trump. Shout out to the good Trump. Big ups to the good Trump.
And here she goes.
It's still under negotiations, but I'm just saying. You know what I'm saying?
I hold the meaning change. Look
I'm
at
just
it.
Saying.
Big ups to the good Trump. Make things
she
happen.
She got away. She's like, okay, hi guys.
Even though Miss O probably stressed you the fuck out with them text messages.
Trump, though, I love him. That is my brother to the day I die. He like Chucky.
Chucky.
The bad Chucky.
Yeah.
Not the bad Chucky, but the good Chucky. Yeah.
Hold on, pause.
trying to clean that up real quick.
Chucky. You talking about Rugrats? Because
we can go with Rugrats.
Yeah, that's
we can
the
go
one.
With Rugrats.
That one. Because
yeah,
Chucky on Rugrats was cool.
But that ain't what y'all originally. Yeah. Okay. You know what?
We're going to go with it, though.
Man, roll with us. Stop asking questions. But we get back kicked off. Stop it.
That's why I said I'm be quiet.
All right, guys. So listen, it is time for Trumpspirations.
Life hacks from your favorite ratchet life coach, All right, guys. So I am back with another Trumpspiration segment. Today, we're going to keep it quick and cool, and we are going to talk about being under the influence. Okay. All right.
I feel guilty already.
I do too.
Why y'all? I ain't trying to come for nobody. I'm just trying to provoke some critical thinking.
There you go.
I'm ready.
All right. So many people say that people reveal their true selves when they are drunk. Scientifically, when you consume alcohol, you enter an induced state of euphoria because the enzymes release the neurotransmitter dopamine from the reward center in your brain, resulting in us experiencing pleasure. Whether alcohol reveals our true selves is another debate for another day. But one cannot argue that it does make us release our inhibitions and live in the moment.
True.
Many call this feeling being under the influence, meaning that everything that we do from the point of consumption changes based on what we have chose to alter our state of mind. Some choose to drink because we feel it's the only way to achieve the feeling of limitless bliss, while others just want to escape reality for the moment. We always associate being under the influence to liquor and drugs, but the truth is we operate under an influence every single day, whether we consciously acknowledge it or not. Right now, someone is working a job they hate because they are under the influence of complacency. Someone is overplanning their next step because they are under the influence of fear. Someone is in a toxic relationship because they are under the influence of the fear of abandonment. When you consider it this way, one must ask themselves, what am I under the influence of? What feeling or mind state am I emotionally consuming that is altering the way I think, the way I behave, and the choices that I make? How does it make me feel when I consume more of it? How does it make me behave? Does this feeling push me forward or hold me back? Does it create a feeling of euphoria or does it leave me drowning in my own personal hell? Are we consuming in moderation or are we overdosing? Just like liquor, when consumed, when you consume the influence, it sends signals to you. Are those signals being transmitted to your internal reward system or to your ego? Evaluate your influence and ask yourself questions and adjust as you see fit. For example, I've recently made it my personal goal to purposely exist under the constant influence of satisfaction. When I look back at my life, I want to be able to smile and say I'm satisfied. Everything that I do, every decision that I make with the intent of being satisfied. If I'm not satisfied, if it does not satisfy what I need, it's not worth doing. My influence of satisfaction has little to do with the world and everything to do with me. For example, I want to be satisfied with my parenting because I know I did my absolute best with the knowledge that I had at that time. I want to be satisfied with the impact that I've made on this earth by knowing that my existence made at least one person better. I operate from a state of satisfaction in every single thing that I do. So I ask you today, what are you under the influence of? What feeling or emotion makes you do what you do? Read into it, look into it, and adjust accordingly if you see fit.
So, money in the bag. Because you're right, man.
Yeah.
Like,
I love
complacency
it.
Complacency is the same thing as,
it's the thing that people don't realize, that a lot of times you're operating from a place that you don't realize that you even have. That's why I was talking earlier, weeks ago, about checking your lens and how you see things. What foundation have you set for yourself before you make any decisions? Mm-hmm. Because a lot of times we're operating from a very toxic, negative place, mm-hmm. yeah. and we don't even know it.
Oh, yeah. I agree. That's totally.
That's money. I think someone was under influence this weekend. I don't know who. I'm not pointing anything. It's probably me, though.
I'm about to say, because if we had to point at anybody at this table.
Well, first, I don't even know what that means right now.
It means that you were probably the one.
I was under some influence.
I think I was probably under some influence.
It was a good influence, though.
I agree.
Outside of the part where I was being, well, then again, I did kind of like it a little bit. So,
being molested.
Yeah.
Oh, my God.
So I want to be
molested.
Can you
not normalize that, please, on documents?
No, please don't. That's not a joking matter. But yeah, it did feel.
You were feeling
good,
touched
though.
Up. Is that better? Right. Is that something better we're gonna say?
It still felt good, regardless.
Yeah.
You know, like, I was like, ooh. Anyway, so that was bomb shit.
Definitely.
Touching on that joint. Titty touching.
I mean,
on
that's
that.
So true too, because I mean, like, they, you definitely have seen different sides of people when it comes down to whatever influence, whether it's drinking or whatever, or even being influenced by other people. You know, you get a chance to see different sides of people. And sometimes it can bring out, I mean.
And I don't know if it's true, if that reveals your true self. But I feel like there is some truth to it, but it just depends. Because again, you also have the other layer of things that people are dealing with on the everyday. You know what I mean? So it's a lot that can go. It's not just always cut and dry.
Yeah. And I think that the reason why they probably say it reveals your true self is because, like, when you're operating and you're not under the influence of, like, say, drinking or whatever, it's like your most of the time you're mindful of what you're saying. You're mindful of what you're doing. Yeah. So, you know, typically if you would have like wanted to cuss that person out, you'd be like, you know what, this is not a good idea. I shouldn't do this. Then if you're drinking, you're kind of like, oh, I'm a cuss. You get all of it. You catch it, all these feelings, all these emotions.
And that's it. You feel like you can do anything. And it's like, you don't care as much. Well, I don't know, because I'm a careful drunk.
And this is, I think I am too. But
I find that hard to believe, but go off. Like, I can't imagine it.
No one is really a careful drunk, because if you're drunk, you're not careful anyway, because you've had too much already.
if you get to the point where you're a drunk.
Yeah. Tipsy is one thing. Drunk is a whole another. I can at least walk straight, one foot in front of the other. I can even probably say my alphabet backwards. I think I did that once or twice in my life.
Once I get drunk, I'm just sleepy. There's like levels. I just get really sleepy.
How do we get on drunkness?
Because I started it out. Transpiration.
Is
under the influence.
Everyone has.
You started it. Like, why you started it?
All right, guys. Oh my goodness, we done just zoomed past. Right.
I know. It's almost nine. That's why I kept a show for you.
I know. So, so listen, what we're gonna do is we're gonna take another quick break, because when we come back, we're just gonna dive right into our interview. We're just gonna talk to Red Grant, because that's what you guys came here tonight. That's what y'all want to do. So we're gonna take another quick break. When we come back, we're going to be live with Red Grant. So do not go anywhere, guys. You are live on the Miss O Show.
Oh, look, we got Connie.
Welcome back. Hi. Thanks for the countdown, Brian.
Brian, listen, Brian is like, look, I'm not laughing.
Oh, man, that's what he was like.
Today's awesome, y'all. Get back on
it. What up, what up, what up, peoples? Welcome back to Miss O Show.
Yes, we are live. We are live. Shout out to all of our listeners. We are getting it together. Shout out to Tamika King, honey. She says that she is satisfied when she has successfully made someone else happy with her services or just giving helpful advice. And she also said that she is fearless when she is drunk. So I am here for it.
Shout out to Miss King. Big ups to Miss King for saying those positive and inspiring words.
Before you even start, I ain't trying to kill your vibe.
All right, so listen, without further ado, I am excited. You guys excited?
Oh my goodness
gracious. Yes.
I am a fan.
So we have live Mr. Red Grant.
DC's on. I clap for myself. I know how to clap for me too. I appreciate
the love. Yes! How are you? Thank you for joining us.
Hey, thanks for having me. I really appreciate y'all. It's an honor to be here with you guys, and I'm super excited about this interview.
Well, we are definitely excited to have you. How you feeling this evening? Oh, wait. Here we go.
First of all, this is an exclusive. I feel like you guys have getting an exclusive tonight. So I want you guys to be, you know, as straightforward and ask the questions that people really want to hear.
Now we truly excited.
Definitely. You gotta bring it right on the Miss O Show. Don't bring it wrong.
Sure. So of course, before we get on to all the details,
do we have an echo?
Can you hear? Is it
gone? I can hear y'all if y'all can hear me.
Oh, can you turn down your volume or something? Yes.
I got the volume. What about right there? Is that good?
Let's see. Yep. That works good. Perfect. Thank you. So before we get all into all the juicy details and everything, if you can just let everyone know a little bit about who you are.
I'm Rodney Red Grant, born and raised in Washington, D.C. I went to school in D.C., Sousa Junior High, Elementary, graduated from Dunbar High School in Washington, D.C. Went on to play football at Savannah State University with the great Shannon Sharp. Then I came back to Washington, D.C. shortly after I returned as a 19-year-old and became a comedian, actor, writer extraordinaire. And from there, people know me from stand-up, know me from creating film and television, and know me from being a father, a husband, and a humanitarian and philanthropist. I've been truly blessed to be in this business for 30 years as a businessman and as an entertainer. And I'm super excited to let people know that I am running for mayor of Washington, D.C. as we speak. I think it's super important for us to get involved with local politics. And I gave up a lot to come back home to service my community and to continue to be a humanitarian and philanthropist. So in short, that's who I am.
Oh my God. Right. That's everything but short. I mean, that's amazing. That is a serious resume. Okay.
So I guess I'm gonna start from the beginning. You came back to DC. I'm pretty sure you was funny in high school. I'm pretty sure you was funny in college, but what was the transition from classroom jokes and stage?
I was never funny in high school. I was never funny in college. I'm still not funny to this day. I only take comedy on stage. I'm a writer. I'm an actor. So when people see me in the street and they think I'm funny, they usually, you know, catch a serious individual. I've always been in entertainment because my mother put me in music real early in my life, where I play instruments like the trumpet, and I sang my head off. I've sung for three presidents and different choirs, and I really feel like I'm more of a singer than I am a comedian. So when people see me and they say, well, you had a super career in comedy, they don't understand that I was told that I wouldn't be a great writer when I was in high school, and I wanted to prove people wrong. So I started writing about the things that was around me in my community, some of the things that people were crying about or that you that might make you sad. I wanted to make them comedy. I was a young kid who had an attitude problem, and God was either going to send me down that wrong road to jail, or he was going to give me an opportunity to make people laugh. And I'm so glad he gave me the opportunity to show the things that are happening in communities around the world, and I can write about them.
That's
awesome.
Wow.
Definitely dope. Definitely
that's
dope.
Amazing. Yeah. Wow. I mean, I didn't
but
even
if you, but that. If you get out there, if you do get out there and you think you're going to just like, you know, snap on me or Joan on me in the cut.
Then you're going to be ready for them. You got some work for them.
Oh, I got big work for them.
I know that's right.
So let's fast forward to now. What inspired you to run for mayor of D.C.?
The people. I was called to run for mayor of D.C. I had a great opportunity to come home to Washington after being back and forth, living in L.A., New York. And, you know, all my family's in D.C., and when I came back home and reestablished my residency here, my resident here, I was speaking to neighbors and friends and just getting involved more with the local politics. And I was seeing how people were really being left out of the process. DC is an interesting place that we live in the capital, that people are treated like secondhand citizens. And I thought that the only way you can either talk about it or you can be involved with it. Mm. And I talked to my wife. We decided not to run as a council member because I'm not a legislator. I wanted to actually run as a mayoral candidate because it's more corporation driven. And I've been running a corporation for the last 30 years. And I wanted to make sure that the city had a person that understood business. You know, I worked for Viacom, creating 25 shows for the network, from BET to MTV to Comedy Central. Super successful career when it comes to executive producing and running a business and a corporation. And DC is a big corporation, so that made me decide which way I was going to go when it came to what office I was going to run for.
Wow, that's awesome. You've done a lot of things in your career, but what we really want to know too is about your mantra, purpose over popularity. Can you tell us a little more about that?
Purpose over popularity is something I live by. I've been popular for a long time, since I was a teenager, probably before that. But I think people need to focus on what their true purpose is here on earth. And once you know your purpose in life, you know that that's way more important than being popular.
Yes. Oh, yeah.
So many people are running after popularity and fame when they really should be just concentrating on what God put them here on earth to do, what their purpose is. Right. I know my purpose here on earth is to make people happy. I know my purpose here on earth is to educate the youth. I know my purpose here on earth is to make sure seniors are looked at and taken care of properly. And, you know, when you get an opportunity to go out and become cultural, like I have, it's only right for you to come back and serve your community and teach people the things you know. Because I am that same person that they are, you know. I'm also a person that could have, you know, could be in that same position. And I am in that same position as we speak. And I don't ever want people to think that they are bigger than the situation. Until we all growing, it's just gonna, you know, then we all on the same level and we need to pull each other up. And I think that's what happens in our community. We forget about one another. That's why I run off of love, care, and respect. And I think that's super important to continue to, you know, put love, care, and respect first in our community. And I'm going to continue to do that. So that's just my purpose. And no matter how famous people think I am, I want them to understand that my purpose is way more important than the famous part.
I know that's right. I know that's right. Could be, as it should be.
Definitely. Definitely. So what has been some of the challenges that you have faced?
What? In what? Comedy? What? In entertainment? No.
You're running for mayor. I'm running for mayor.
Oh. I think it's funny that people ask me that question, like, what are some of my challenges? I just think that politics is weird when it comes to how they have been running politics forever. And me being an outsider to them, I think when I first made my announcement, people felt like I shouldn't have a position in this game, or, you know, who does he think he is trying to run for office, you know, against us. And I felt like it became me against them at one point. And what I like to tell people is, you know, you can never allow people to put you in a box. Mm-hmm. You can't allow people to say what you can do and cannot do. Because when you are in this situation and God gives you the intelligence to be, you know, able to pull off and be a true leader, you know, you can't allow people to scare you out of your mission. You know, that's their problem. That's why I read the four agreements. I feel like, you know, you can't take it personal what people are saying. But what one thing I can say is that we are in a great position right now, and our grassroots movement is one of the most powerful movements that's come through D.C. in a long time when it comes to mayoral candidate. We have over 400 volunteers working our way up to 1,500. We have raised money that they thought that we couldn't raise. And I always tell people to make sure you go to grantformayordc.com, become a volunteer, and donate what you can, because we are an independent candidate. I am an independent candidate. And it's very important that the people and the residents and support the movement, because we don't have big PACs that's supporting us. We only have the people that support us. So I think the challenges is not challenges that are obstacles that we can't get over. They're more challenges of people's attitudes about how they don't think we should be in the race at all. And but come November 8th, they will all be saying, oh, we should have not doubted the situation, I can say.
I'm here for you. Let them know.
Right. So I'm going to go on a little play of words right here on your mantra. Do you think your popularity will help you with your purpose?
Does my popularity help me with my purpose? I think your purpose creates your popularity. I think when you go after your the dreams that and visions that are in your head that God gives you, you become popular in those realms. I think people get caught up sometimes when they become popular And that's the problem. It's not the problem of being popular. The problem is once you become popular in whatever way you claim what is popular, when you start to actually see yourself differently, like you're bigger than the moment, then that's when popularity becomes a problem. So, you know, I get 1.6 million impressions a month, right? And to some that's small and to some that's huge, but I just know it happens every month and it's growing as we speak. And I think that because of those impressions, I think people have said that Red has one of the best opportunities to win this race that we're in. And I know the people who I'm, some of the people that I'm running against feel like I'm using that to, you know, put myself in a position, but I just always lean on God. I know it's not me, it's always God. I know God put me here in this situation. He knows where I've been at, he knows where I'm coming from, and vice versa, what, you know, you guys, you know, look at you guys, y'all podcast is gonna be, if not already, the most popular podcast in the world, because you guys know the vision. You know, you guys know what it is. It's not what other people think. It's what you know and what you think and the work you put into it. But if you start listening to what other people feel, then that y'all gonna fall off, because you're gonna start thinking like they think. A lot of people don't think that they can be as big as they are. I believe I can. I believe that God has so much for me. I mean, we all looked at the Kanye West special. We seen how he came from, you know, wearing them big jeans and, you know, to being a fashion guru. And they can say whatever they want to about Kanye. And shout out to him. Shout out to my man Cootie, who I started doing comedy with. And just to see how people grow, you know, it's amazing. So you never can worry about what others think about how popular you are, what you're going through. You just gotta just stay focused on your goals and your dreams, and know that if he got you in this situation, just go hard as you can, go harder than they can, and go for the win.
Mm. Oh my gosh!
You're coaching the locker room
I love it, but that is so true. I mean, you know, you have definitely have to be yourself. And I mean, there's gonna be a lot of naysayers, a lot of negative energy.
You get a lot of extra positive.
Yeah, definitely. So another quick question: what do you feel that DC needs? You know, like what I mean, like you're from there and you can experience different things in the city. You know the people and all of that. So what do you feel is like some of the major things that DC needs and what you would like to see happen within, you know, you becoming the mayor? We're gonna talk about that.
I think DC needs great leadership. And what I mean when I say that, you know, when you're a leader, you're a person that is straightforward with people, whether it's something that they want to hear or don't want to hear. People respect when you tell them the truth or tell them what they know, you know, what you know, the knowledge that you have. And even if you can't fix everything, people respect that you are being straightforward with them. And a lot of times our residents in our city are not being heard. And I think me being the type of leader in my life, you know, with my programs, like Don't Shoot Guns, Shoot Cameras, Beyond Your Block, and my ability to be a listener is something that a leader should bring to the table, because, you know, a lot of times people just want to be heard. And a lot of citizens and residents in the city have, they've been given a closed ear for the last 8 years. And I think, you know, we have to get our public safety under control immediately. And I think the best way to do that is to bring more programming back to our city. You know, a lot of programs was taken out of the city for whatever reason, even though we have an $18.5 billion budget. Mm-hmm. I just think that people forget that youth programming is what kept a lot of us out of trouble. After school programming kept us out of trouble. Vocational programming kept us out of trouble and kept us employed. So, you know, we definitely need to concentrate on our youth and give them the care and love and respect that they deserve. And if we don't, you know, we're going to have a lot of youth out here mad as heck, like nobody don't care. And, you know, once people think that you don't care, it's a situation that you can't turn it around. I'm sorry, man. I'm at the campaign office. There's a lot going on right now around me. So, but you know, we have to concentrate on our youth. We have to also concentrate on people being able to afford to live in Washington, D.C.
You know, imagine that.
Well, we could afford it, and we have to bring back affordable housing. And when I say that, we have to make these developers that's building around here develop for people who can afford it, like afford to live there. You know, why can't we create places that have great amenities for people with lower incomes?
Right.
You know, because I know when I move into a place and I don't have as much money, but if you put amenities around me right, I feel better and I do better. And I become a part of a better situation. So you got to make the environment better. You know, we need to get more lighting in our communities to help with public safety. And we got to really sit down and talk to our youth, and we got to catch them young. We can't wait till they're a certain age and think that they're going to change then. We got to catch them young, and we really got to give them job opportunities real early in life. And when we do that, it's gonna change the face of how we see cities. And DC can become a model that other cities will, you know, want to be. So I'm excited about becoming a leader and the mayor of Washington, DC, because I know the programs that I'm gonna implement are gonna change so many people's lives. And I think it's time for people to understand that people care.
Yes, absolutely.
Absolutely.
Okay. Speaking of programs, let's talk about your nonprofit outreach program, Don't Shoot Guns, Shoot Cameras. Can you tell us some more about it?
Well, Don't Shoot Guns, Shoot Cameras, I came up with a while ago, but I implemented it 3 years ago. I approached Yasmin Selena from the Hustlers Guild. And we thought it would be a good summer program to implement, like a summer youth program for our kids to learn filmmaking from beginning to end. They write the scripts themselves, they shoot the scripts, they edit the scripts. And it's so amazing to see these kids use their creative minds, and they never thought they could make movies. So for them to make movies, they get super excited. They're the directors, they're the writers, they're the producers, executive producers. And, you know, we also give them stipends, so it's like a summer job. So they, you know, they also make money, and we start placing these kids in on different sets so they can go and work with a lot of Hollywood studios and a lot of television studios. And going to be some of our next Spike Lee's and our, you know, next Quentin Tarantino's and next Red Grant's, you know. But it's something it's something that helped me out. Super, it was super important in my life. And I just wanted to share with the youth in my city. So we did DC the first year, then this last year we did DC and LA. And this year we're going to do something special for the kids. We're going to combine my program Beyond Your Block, which helps young men to get off their block, to see some culture. And it's a mentoring program that just shows you when you're off your block, it's other things to see than just your block. And I think that's very important, because when you don't get off your block, you only know one thing. So we're going to do something special this summer and take the kids away to shoot the film. And we're now implementing the same program into high schools and middle schools so they can learn filmmaking from beginning to end at an early age with TikTok and with YouTube and with IG and so many other avenues. And then you got the metaverse coming out and you got so many different things that they can take advantage of. I just think this is a great way to show them how to be creative and make money at the same time. So, you know, that program is super special to me because I come from a film and television background, and I just want to share that with so many youth. And I appreciate, like, the Hustlers Guild coming in and just being that person that helps drive the program and keep pushing.
Okay.
That's the set.
That's big business right there. That's
I love the fact that everything you said tonight is about the people. You know, I think that's so good because a lot of times, you know, we vote for people and we don't realize, like, ultimately, we want our voices to be heard. We want our problems to be solved. We want people to hear us. And a lot of times, a lot of times these people that we pull in, they don't hear because they're not experiencing what we're experiencing.
You know what I mean?
They don't understand because they're not in the same boat as we are. They have never been. So I think it's really dope that you're coming from a place where you've experienced it, you understand it, so you know what the youth needs. And I mean, I think at this time that we're living in now, it's even more prevalent that we have someone that is literally going to be like, I'm here, I hear you, let's make some moves. You know what I mean? Because we gotta make some serious moves.
Well, you know, we're living in a society where we are so separate, right? And I'm so glad I'm not a politician, I'm a humanitarian. And I'm always keep that mantra around because I don't ever want to get that, even though I'm dealing with policies and I'm dealing with, you know, political world, I want people to understand that my human life is so much more important and, you know, human value is everything to me. I think that if we concentrate on human value, then we solve a lot of problems in our communities. And one thing I know, even though I'm an African-American, I'm a black man, I want people to understand that, you know, we're kings and queens out here, and we're open to creating with a lot of people. And I think once we put harness on ourselves to do better, you know, we're start gaining that respect that we deserve in our society and continue to gain that respect. But, you know, we have to continue to work with one another and be better to one another and build our communities to the point where everybody understands that we are a community and we are strong together and we do love each other and we do care about each other. We do respect each other and we love and we care and respect others. And that's what's going to continue to make our communities around the city, around the country, around the globe be better communities.
100%.
Good stuff. Sure. So, another quick one for you. So I understand the humanitarian efforts and the nonprofit, which is great because I do believe that hasn't been around since Barry in DC. But with all of those efforts that you have currently going out there right now, like, what is your frontline deal? Like, what are you trying to change? Immediate if possible, and politics, you're a humanitarian, but politics is still politics, so you still have to go and jump through hoops and the red tape.
Well, I mean, you know, one thing I noticed, you know, about politics in DC is that we sometimes don't live. Team Red. sometimes the leadership don't lead by example. I feel like when you are a leader and you have a mayor, you have council members, you have ANCs, and you have police chiefs, and you have attorney generals, and a lot of these individuals don't even get along with one another. So I think public safety starts at the top. You know, when we as a community start seeing our leaders not getting along, what do we feel like, you know, we're going to get along? So I just want to change that whole atmosphere of politics in D.C. We're going to get the services done for our community, but we also have to be an example to our community. And once we become an example to our communities, then everything else will, you know, fall in line. Policy-wise, I know that we're 25% less safer in our city right now than we were 10 years ago. That means that D.C. has went from 85 murders to 217 murders.
Real quick.
I know homelessness is rampant here in D.C., where we're the number one homeless population per capita to any other city in America, L.A. being 4 and Las Vegas being 9th. I know that affordable housing is not affordable, and we're not putting pressures on the banks to put pressure on the developers to develop properties that people can afford to live in. I do know this. I know our public education is super in the red right now, when we could be gaining momentum and being just as smart as other cities. So I'm looking at things like that. How do we make these things better so we can live in, we can be the example of, oh, DC was here, but now they're there. And it's because a leader came in and they really focused on this and they really motivated people. Now the morale is high and, you know, our city government can run like it's supposed to. And that's the job of the mayor to make sure that, you know, city services are run properly. That's their job. So I want to make sure I come in and make sure not only are the city services running properly, but the morale within inside of the city services are there. And people want to come to work and people want to be happy and do their job.
Good stuff.
We definitely need it. I mean, so how, tell everyone, so listeners, how can they support, like, how can they support your movement? How can they do it? What can they do?
No, you guys, and you guys can start by lead by example too. They can go to grantformayordc.com. That's GRANT for mayordc.com. And just become a volunteer, you know, and donate. They can just push that donate button and every little bit counts. So, you know, I would say just being involved that way. And when we go out knocking doors like we do all the time and we go out canvassing, come be a part of the canvassing. Come be a part of the door knocking. Come be a part of the waves and everything that we're doing in the community engagement. And don't just sit at home and be like, well, Red, that it looks fun what they're doing. Nah, come and be involved. And I think that you guys will have a great time just seeing how people, their whole spirit changes when we show up. And I think that's super important that we continue to show up in droves to let our community know that we are coming together. We are a better community, and we're going to continue to be a better community. So I can just tell people to make sure they can follow my Instagram, Red Grants, and just follow the movement. They can go to my YouTube, Red Grants, and they can just follow everything we're doing. But that grantformayordc.com is super important, and I want to continue to motivate people to get involved. And you know, our team is the strongest team in the city right now. And I believe it's because, you know, I got some of the smartest people around me. God has truly blessed me with some of the most incredible individuals that understand politics, on a whole nother level. And I'm just honored to be, you know, working with some of the smartest individuals in the world that can come in and help run services. And I think that's what it is. You know, you got to put smart people around you, you know, as a leader, and talented people. And that's what brings you a Super Bowl.
Right. Yes. All right, Tom Brady. I see you. Hey, man.
call me Doug Williams. Williams.
I see.
Well, I mean, listen, we are so appreciative of you coming in here tonight.
Yes.
Wish you so much. Yes.
Thank you, guys.
And congratulations. Okay.
Congratulations
on that win.
It's been a hard 8 years.
Yeah, changes right now.
Yeah,
because
both of you
guys. Both of us
live in
D.C.
Hey, you got to look. Hey, I tell you like this. Y'all got to come by the office, or I want to bring a yard sign to you guys and put in your yard if y'all got a yard. If not, even just put it in your family's yard. And, you know, our office is right here on Georgia Avenue across from Howard University, our campaign office. We stay hyped in here. Y'all can always pull up.
Listen,
don't say that.
I'm dead serious.
We will go live from the headquarters.
Y'all, hello. That'll be cool if y'all come and go live from the campaign office. That'll be super cool.
You telling the wrong people. We knocking at your campaign door.
Look, you see what's happening is right here, man.
That's the ad.
Yeah.
This is Howard University gym. We're right here. We got the big bay windows, and you know we're here. So we would love for you guys to go live here.
We're gonna be right here. I'm gonna talk to your people, and your people gonna talk to me, and we're gonna be fun. Well, again, we thank you so very much for joining us tonight. Again,
really
quick, just let the Miss O listeners know how they can follow you and support everything.
You can go to Red Grant on IG, Red Grant Labs on Twitter, Red Grant on Facebook, RedGrant.com, and you can go to GrantForMayorDC.com. There's so many places to follow. Or you just Google the situation. We do have a new show called PolitiTalk. I want people to go that I created. My first guest was CeeLo Green.
Okay.
And it's heavy. And my next guest is Trayon White. A lot of people think me and Trayon are running against each other. They don't know we're friends. And I always tell people that you got to get involved with the political process to understand what's going on. And our third guest is Ms. Eleanor Holmes Norton. So we got that coming for you guys. So, but right now, you can go to my YouTube and see the CeeLo Green PolitiTalk episode and just tap in.
I love it. Yes. Well, family now. See you soon.
Y'all family. Don't act up. Don't act like y'all ain't family after we hang up.
We need something to eat.
We can just bring containers. We can do a little something too.
It's all good. I accept all donations, all gifts. I appreciate it.
All gifts and all donations.
Thank you.
Well, again, we bless you so very much, and we thank you again for joining us. And my blessing, success.
I want y'all to make sure y'all come to the inauguration. It's gonna be awesome.
Oh yeah, speaking of existence,
I appreciate y'all.
So much blessings.
Blessings to y'all.
See you soon.
We're about to be honest.
Listen, guys, we're going to take a very, very quick break. And when we come back, we're going to be going into our final segment, which is, you got to stay tuned to find out what it is. Because I'm not going to tell y'all. Right. Y'all just got to stay tuned. All right? It's the Miss O Show. We're swinging in the night. We'll be right back.
Gonna be under the table. I'm gonna have a skirt put right here.
The Miss O Show is hiring.
I'm just gonna stick my head out. And Brian, you better not say nothing.
The Miss O Show is hiring. Male personality.
Must come with own segment.
Are we back?
Yes, we are. And this time we coming back to you, Barry Page.
Shit, y'all are back. Y'all are back.
Look, Look,
he got one job, guys.
His name is now listen, Mark One Job Swing. Listen.
One job. God, that's damn. It.
Brian has not given me a countdown in 2 weeks.
Because Brian is done with your ass.
I need 2 weeks.
He said, is done what? With y'all.
Countdown.
He said, what you need it for?
That part. Get your life together.
OJ.
Listen.
Shout out to
Red Grant.
Red Grant. Shout out to him. You know, I mean, at the end of the day, I love the fact that what he has on his mind with his campaign is love, taking care of the people, giving back, making sure that, you know, the different things that's happening in the city are going to be addressed. I mean, I think that what I said before, because both of you guys live in DC, like, we have so many people that do not experience what's going on. So it's extremely hard for them to make changes because they have not experienced it. Exactly. You know, they don't care. They can't feel it because they haven't felt it.
Right.
So a lot of times they're basing things off of, you know,
what's politically correct.
Right. Yeah. Exactly.
And I mean that in the most literal way.
Possible. Most people view DC as good places to go, but bad parking and expensive living.
It's gentrified. They have a gentrified view.
Well, then if you move southern of the Anacostia, then it's different. You
know, a lot of people here, and it really kind of angers me at this point. There's a lot of people that live here, that especially a lot of the transplants, and they come here I'm a transplant. I said some of them.
Okay.
Some of them come and then they don't even venture to that area at all. Like,
what area?
Oh yeah.
They don't. They claim, I love DC. This, that. Yeah. Okay, go to the real part of DC.
Right.
They go on U Street, Connecticut, and they think, I've been to DC.
Georgetown.
You have not.
But I'm. I mean,
Southern
Avenue,
Alabama Avenue.
So Southeast is.
You're one of them.
I'm not going to Baltimore and go to where they filmed The Wire. Like, why not? Right. Because why?
Because it's.
First
why?
Of all, food? That. Yeah.
Food is good.
Food.
Southeast got some good steakhouse in the world.
Okay, but I don't have to go to where they filmed The Wire to get food.
Hood delicacies are a thing.
That's
my favorite kind of food. I'm from Oklahoma, and I frequent Southeast.
I'm gonna take you to like Eddie's or something.
Yes, get a good old carry out.
A nice little grease.
Yeah.
On your cheat day. Only on your cheat day. We gonna mess around. We just gonna be like,
honey, listen.
I'm gonna be like, bring hobby through, and we gonna go stop at a spot. And, you know,
God, please film it, cause I just wanna see how she gonna.
Oh, nigga, you gonna be there too? What the fuck?
You gonna see how she gonna?
You gonna be there too?
She gonna be like, ooh, the thing is that y'all have to understand. Like, I did, like, I partied in Baltimore. I wasn't like
partying. Yeah.
No, what I'm saying is I go where the hell I want to go. Yeah. I'm going to go to Baltimore and I want to, like, I don't have a purpose of going in certain areas. I don't have to. If I go to Philadelphia, I'm going to Philadelphia for a specific reason. I don't have to go. Well, that's true. I live my life a totally different way, and I have literally worked my ass off to live my life a totally different way. You know what I'm saying? Like, I'm from Delaware. I'm born and raised there. I lived in New Jersey for 6 years. I lived up there. You know what I'm saying? I moved down here with my daughter, just her and I. And so for me, I don't, like, how I operate and how I move is how I choose to move. Like, it's not like, I don't want to go to where they shot The Wire at because it's grimy, it's this and that. Right. I don't have a fucking reason to go there. Yeah. Like, truthfully, I don't. Yeah.
Here's my thing. So I was born uptown, Northwest. I ended up moving from Northwest to Southeast. And this is all within my early years.
Yeah.
Northwest, Southeast, Oxon Hill, Fort Washington. So we all know Fort Washington was the nice area of PG County at one point in time. So live nice places, live bad places. I like where I live in DC now just because it's legitimately quiet. I see people walking their dogs past. Do I want to live in Southeast? I have no problem with going. But right, it's the same thing.
I'm not living it.
Like, I can, I can enjoy pulling up, mm-hmm. but that's my, I don't have any problem with it because I can, when I pull up, I'm still comfortable. But where I choose to lay my head mm-hmm. is something else.
I'm the same way. I can't live there, but I'll go there. So I go to Southeast a lot. Actually, I volunteer in Southeast at the Boys and Girls Club a lot, just because it's, that's just like, I like volunteering basically, but I like the vibe. I also go to like a lot of go-go events out there, like yeah, festivals. See, I just like the vibe. No, I'm not saying, I don't go to the go-go, but like, you know how they have like the family mm-hmm. festivals and right. stuff like that. I like the vibe. The vibe of that area is nice to me. Even though, you know, it's a little hood sometimes, but it's real. That's why I like it. I love my time in Silver Spring.
That's good
like,
though.
The
I
nice
mean,
part of Silver
I think that's yeah. that's good. And I think the beauty of, and I say this all the time, I think the beauty of even this show is that this show shows how we all have different walks of life. We see mm-hmm. things differently. Our lives are differently. What we value is differently. How we, I mean, like all of everything about us is differently. And that's beautiful.
Yeah.
Because mm-hmm. I would never knock how you live your life. I would never knock how you live your life. I would hope nobody would knock how I live my life, because at the end of the day, we all choose how we choose to live, what we find pleasure in, the things we don't find pleasure in. That is the beauty of all of us. And I think that that is so huge, because so many times us in our communities, if you're not living this way or doing this, or if you do that, or if you don't do this, and it's like judgment. And it's like, right. there's no reason for that, because all of us literally are living our lives the way we choose yeah. to live them. And there's yeah. no right and there's no wrong. It is literally what makes you happy, what brings you peace, and where you find, you know, solitude in all these situations. I think for me, again, you know, I am a transplant here. And for the longest time, I didn't go any damn where. I literally would put my navigation on to get my ass to work in D.C. and get my ass back home.
There's a lot of people that do that.
And I still do that right now.
I was the opposite. I was everywhere. Now I do that.
Literally. I mean, my fiance was like, babe, you got to learn how where you're going. He's like, you can't just use your navigation all the time. You got to learn where you're going. You need to know your directions. And I'm like, no, my navigation tells me point A and point B. I can go from here and I can go from there. But that's just like,
I just feel like, I get it, but I just feel like sometimes too, it's just nice sometimes to just explore.
Just drive
right. and just see what's around. You know what I mean? Just to see, because that's how I run into all the good food spots is yeah, by just driving yeah. around. I just feel like it's just nice to do. It's not mandatory.
I turn on my ways nice. Coming here.
Yeah,
you know what I'm saying?
I don't know where I'm going. Well, but I'm just saying, like, it's just nice to at least look at the areas and figure out, yeah. you know, like, that's how I've had my most, some of my funnest moments,
yeah,
you know,
just
and
being
it's unexpected.
Lost in the moment.
Yeah, it was
being lost in the moment.
So I just highly encourage it. Yeah. That's my thing. It's not mandatory. I just highly encourage it just yeah. because the vibe is dope when you actually.
I know where in the hell I'm going most times out of 10, but I use the Waze for two reasons. Cameras and cops. Not for direction. Cameras and cops. Because yeah, outside of that, I might as well use Google.
I don't like Waze.
I don't know. For me, again, I'm very intentional. So.
Shit. We ain't even get to the topic.
It was your fault. Right.
So, yeah, what topic?
Well, see. The shenanigans happens when y'all don't even know the shenanigans is happening.
You don't
did
know
you start your shenanigans?
I really did.
What was the
Well, listen, unfortunately,
it is
9:58 and
it is still tornado one outside.
Tornado. I know.
It was windy.
It was so windy. It was so much going on during the Red Granny interview.
Yes,
it was stuff flying all over the studio, but
everywhere.
Y'all didn't see that. Shout out to our engineer, Brian. He made sure y'all didn't see that. But
outside
we was like
flying
around tornado-ish.
He was helping too.
He was giving the sound effects.
Listen.
He helped too.
Listen. Well, we thank you so very much for tuning in to the Miss O Show. We thank you, Rhett Grant,
big
for
ups, Rhett.
Calling in, dialing in, videoing. We wish you so much success. We know you're going to win. We're going to be there in the operation.
Right down the street. I'm coming up to pick up my yard flag, bro.
And make sure that you follow us. Well, should follow me, because, I mean, us is, you know, like I'm trying to merge it together. But it's work. Follow me at Paris K Style. How can they follow you, Barry Beige?
Swinging underscore shenanigans, Mark Swinging, Facebook. You might catch me in the streets now, but Barry Beige is coming soon.
Barry Beige.
Barry Beige
coming soon. I'm gonna have to hit that joint like Bond.
Hold on, Barry Beige coming soon to what? If you make it a brand, you owe me some money.
Barry Beige.
Let me catch a trademark on there. Run me my cash.
For cold games or
something. All right, so for me, Queen of Streams on Instagram, KWENOF Stream. And then a car on Facebook, and NENNACARR.
Yes.
I'm not going to do a lot of business.
And shout out to Sudan the Man. Make sure that you follow him. Now we got something.
Stop taking pictures.
She like, I'm not pictures.
I'm like, I know it's up here because we got like a whole thingy.
Brian is like,
it's 10 o'clock. Y'all off the clock. Or at least I am.
Follow our show photographer if you need anything for your weddings and your baby showers and your divorce parties and your engagement parties and all that good stuff.
Your stripper parties and all that kind of stuff. Yeah, all that.
Everything. All that. Make sure that you follow him. And honestly, call him. It's even better. 703-864-2468.
Because he don't ask the messages enough.
And he'll switch up his follow stuff in a minute. So you want to call him instead. That way you catch him. Thank you, everyone, so very much for tuning in to the Miss O Show. See you next time.